Hi there people, welcome back to a very quick video, but tonight we are looking at Fubo TV. This stock has seen a big drop in the past month. We are down by around 34% so far. Obviously the past 2 or 3 days have been in the green for this one, now up by around 10% from the lows, and the past week is pulling itself back up. We can see that from the lows of the week of $26.38, we are now up by around 15%. And the real question for this video is, should you buy this stock or should you avoid it, being as now we are ever so slightly in the green today with Fubo TV. Well, of course, in this one I am giving you all of my personal opinions, so please make sure to watch until the end. So focusing mainly today, we can see that the stock price is pretty flat. Apparently, according to Google, we are down by 0.3%. So of course, it is still down, we can see, but it is by a very minimal amount. And again, the past 5 or so days are still in the red because of the previous Thursday. But we can see that from this low on the Friday the 5th, we are actually up by around 13%. So that is quite interesting stuff. Now, what I want to focus on tonight is the earnings and of course, a few other interesting pieces of information which you may want to know. So we're going to start off by looking at these earnings. You can see on screen right now that the share, that basically the earnings were in the red. The Q4 earnings were missed by around this point here. So of course they were actually minus 2.29. We were expecting them to be only minus 2.73. So of course things were down quite a significant amount. You could be asking yourself, is this important or not? Well, of course I will leave you guys to talk about that one in the comment section. We can see that recently the company has exceeded revenue, as their revenue has touched over 100 million in quarter four, which is capping the strongest year to date. Pretty amazing stuff to see. I am happy to see this one. Of course, over $100 million in one quarter alone is amazing, and of course for this company is even better. So important things to note is that now they close 2020 with around 500,000 paid subscribers, so the official number is 547,880, which is good. Now going forwards, I can see a lot of potential for this company if they do kind of, you know, get their act together a bit and start thinking of new ways to make money. And that is what we are potentially talking about now, because it is something that we could be seeing more of on the horizon. So we're going to quickly have a look down here on Yahoo Finance again, where it talks about an article where the CEO has said that sports betting is a key area for them to focus in. And I 100% agree with them. I think that is a very interesting statement to make. I think going forwards, it could have a big impact on the share's price. Of course, so far revenue was good, but we just need this to improve a bit more for the company to start making a bit more of a decent profit. And again, sports betting, as you may or may not know, is a very widely used sector, and of course it is a very widely profitable sector, and I think this is interesting for the company. Again, if they are able to expand into sports betting even further, it absolutely could help their company to gain a lot more revenue going forwards. So I think that is amazing. I think if this does continue to happen, we could be looking at a profitable company which has quite a decent, you know, potential going forwards into the future. But at the minute, you have to be asking yourself, is this stock a buy? Well, first things first, look at the most recent earnings. Like I said, we are actually worse than expected. However, overall, 100 million is not too bad. I think this one could continue to grow into the next few months. But would I buy this stock right now? Honestly, I think it is hard to say. At $30, it's at one of the best points that we have been seeing. I am happy that it has sold off in the past month or so, and now we are in a more realistic area for the price. I think this is a good thing. I think we do have that potential to see this one start to rally ever so slightly again. When it comes to growth, I wouldn't expect too big growth on this stock in the next few weeks and months. I think it definitely could rise. I wouldn't be surprised if we were to pass $35 in the next month or two. But honestly, when it comes to growth figures, I just don't think it is going to be the largest that we have seen out of all of the stocks out there at the moment. So of course, this stock could be an interesting buy. I do want to hear what you guys have to say in the comment section. I thought I would just bring you a quick update on it, because it has been a while since we last looked at it, and we have some very interesting stuff which we talked about in this very quick episode. Again, if you do want to see a bit more of an in-depth look on this one, we have done it before, so make sure to type in N2S Finance and Fubo, and you may be able to find that video. And if you can't, of course, please do drop me a comment, and I can remake a bit more of an in-depth video in the near future. Thank you for watching this one, though. I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye until then.